And you know, there's mountains that are big, and there's mountains that are small, and montañas grandes and montañas pequeñas. But I believe that we all have mountains in our life. Amen. And I want to continue. Thank you. I want to continue with this series that we have been teaching on faith, having the faith of God, teniendo la fe de Dios. And we started talking about having crazy faith, teniendo fe loca. Amen. You remember that? And then we went from having crazy faith to having lazy faith. Amen. Are you here with me? Because some of us can have crazy faith in one area of our life, but then we can have lazy faith in another area of our life. Podemos tener fe loca, por decirlo así, en una área, y fe floja en otra área. Amen. And I spent 2 weeks on lazy faith because, you know, we were talking about this lame man in the book of Luke. Estamos hablando de este hombre, aleluya, que no podía caminar, este hombre que estaba paralítico en el libro de Lucas. And we're going to go back to this man because there's a lot to this story. Hay mucho en esta historia. Amen. And I want to talk to you today not about lazy faith. I want to talk to you today about trading faith. Say trading faith.
Trading.
Say trading faith.
Trading.
That's what I want to talk to us about today, is trading the faith that got you here for the faith that's going to take you there. Amen? Is trading the faith that got you here for the faith that's going to take you there. Vamos a cambiar fe. Así se llama el título, cambiando la fe. Vamos a cambiar la fe que nos trajo hasta aquí por la fe que nos va a llevar más allá. Are you hearing me? So let's go back to the book of Luke chapter 5 and the libro de Lucas capítulo 5, and we're going to start at verse 17. And then we'll go from there. Y'all ready?
Amen.
Are y'all ready?
Amen.
Look at your neighbor and say, here we go.
Here we go.
If you're taking notes, I would encourage you to take notes. Hallelujah, tome notas. It says, now it happened on a certain day, as he was teaching, that there were Pharisees and teachers of the law sitting by, who had come out of every town of Galilee, Judah, and Jerusalem, and the power of the Lord was present to heal them. Verse 18, 5:18. Si lo tiene en español, por favor, sígueme. 18 says, then behold, men, another version of the Bible says, some men brought on a bed a man who was paralyzed, whom they sought to bring in and lay before him. And when they could not find how they might bring him in because of the crowd, they went up on the house top and let him down with his bed through the tiles into the midst before Jesus. We talked about this man. Hablamos acerca de este hombre. So let me pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for this word. I pray that you open up every heart. Abre todo corazón. And I pray that you speak. Father, you know who this word is for. Tú sabes para quién esta palabra es esta palabra. And our prayer, God, is that you would just begin to minister to the people right now. Empieza a ministrar, Señor, a la gente en este momento a través de tu palabra. Lord, I decrease so that you may increase in my life in the name of Jesus. And all of God's people say,
amen.
Amen and amen. So, we have been talking about these four guys that had crazy faith, right? Hemos estado hablando de estas cuatro personas que tenían esa fe loca. Like these guys had crazy faith. They said, you know what? We know Jesus is here. Aquí está Jesús. So we're going to go and we're going to bring our friend Juan. Remember John? We called him John. The Bible doesn't say that was his name, but we named him John. We said, we're going to go get John because Jesus is healing and we want our friend John to be healed. Queremos que Juanito esté, aleluya, sea sano. So vamos a ir a traernos a... So they go, amen, and they bring John, aleluya, to Jesus so that Jesus can heal him, aleluya. And when they get there, the house is packed. La casa está llena. And now the house is packed, so they look at John. Miran a Juanito and say, John, don't worry about it. We got a plan. We got a plan. Tenemos un plan. We can't get you in through the door. But listen, I know you're probably scared of heights and you've never been this high because you're paralyzed, right? You can't move, so you've never been that high. So we're going to take you on top of the roof. Vamos a subirte arriba del techo. And then the Bible says that they began to tear the tiles. Empezaron a romper el techo. And they laid this lame man, hallelujah, in front of Jesus, en frente de Jesús, right? On a mat. The Bible says that he was on a mat que estaba en una cama, en una, en como una alfombra, podemos decirlo así. Y lo bajaron hacia abajo, in front of Jesus. And I don't know about you, but if I was this lame man, si yo era esta persona, up to this point, hasta este punto, man, everything's going good for me. Right? He goes from the outside to front row seats. De afuera a las filas de adentro. Not only does he get in front of Jesus, but he begins to talk to him. Empieza a hablar con él. So this is pretty good. Esto es muy bueno.
Amen.
Amen. Are you here with me? So listen, up to this point, this man has been operating on somebody else's faith. Este hombre ha estado operando, aleluya, con la fe de alguien más. Are you here with me? He is, this man, aleluya, is about to get a miracle. Este hombre está a punto de recibir un milagro. Are you here with me today? Hallelujah. So they take him there up to Jesus. Hallelujah. And they take him so close that he is talking to him. Are you hearing me? Jesus was not through with this man. Jesús no había terminado todavía con este hombre. Are you here with me? Because something was about to happen in his life. And if we read the scripture, we'll continue to read. Vamos a seguir leyendo. And verse 20, versículo 20. And he said to their faith, this is Jesus talking, said to him, this faith, or their faith, has made you well. But this version here says, man, your sins are forgiven you. Tus pecados te son perdonados. Jesus didn't tell him you're healed. He just said your sins are forgiven.
Yes.
Jesús le dijo, tus pecados te son perdonados.
Yes.
Is that what he said?
Yes.
Hallelujah. Is that what it said?
Yes.
Because listen, this man, he didn't have faith to get up from his house to go to Jesus. Este hombre no tenía la fe, mi hermano, para levantarse e ir a Jesús. This man didn't have the faith to get on top of the roof. Este hombre no tenía la fe para subirse arriba del techo. This man didn't have the faith to be lowered down by himself in front of Jesus, de bajarse el mismo en frente de Jesús. This man was operating, say, somebody else's faith. And some of you are here today because of somebody else's faith. Algunos de nosotros estamos aquí like it's God's grace and mercy that got you here. Like some of us, we think we're so good for God already that we forget that if it wasn't for God's grace and His mercy and His favor, hallelujah, that we would not be here today. Somebody prayed you here, believe it or not, whether you know it or not, lo crea usted o no lo crea, alguien oró por usted para que usted estuviera aquí. And you're here because of somebody else's prayer. Right? Look at your neighbor and tell him, I am here because of somebody else's prayer. Like God's kindness and goodness and favor has been over me, has been upon me. La bondad de Dios, el favor de Dios, la misericordia de Dios ha estado sobre mí. You know why we didn't die in that car accident? Because of somebody else's prayer. You know why we didn't go to the cuckoo house? Because of somebody else's prayer. You know what? We're not in a hospital because of somebody else's prayer. Like somebody else stood in the gap for us. Alguien más se puso en la brecha por nosotros, mis hermanos. Aleluya. Para orar. Aleluya. To have us here today. Can I get an amen, somebody? Is there anybody in here today that can say, I thank the Lord for somebody else's prayer? Aleluya. Thank you, Jesus. So this man is here. And the thing about it is that grace will get you here. But a faith-filled, hallelujah, decision will take you there. Say that with me. Grace will get me here. But a faith-filled decision will take me there. Grace got him in front of Jesus. But this man had to activate his faith to get him there. Where's there? To his purpose. To whatever God had for him. Su propósito, lo que Dios tenía para él. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Are you here with me? I said, are you here with me? Some of you don't believe me. Are you here with me today? We have to have faith. We have to have faith. Can you move this? Let's move it over here real quick. And let me see that mat real quick, Pastor. Or just Seth, somebody. Just put it right. So, this is a mat, right?
It's an exercise mat. But we're going to use it as a mat to
do what this man was in a mat like this. El hombre estaba en una como esa. This man was lowered in front of Jesus. His faith didn't get him there. Somebody else's faith got him there, right?
Yes, amen.
La fe de alguien más lo trajo aquí. But faith will keep him down there. And he trades the faith that got him here for the faith that's going to get him up. La fe lo trajo aquí. Y aquí está acostado. Y la fe lo va a mantener acostado hasta que él cambie la fe que lo trajo aquí por la fe que lo va a levantar. Did you hear me? You have to be willing to trade the faith that got you to where you are. There's faith that got you to get saved. But you're going to need to trade that faith for the faith that's going to take you to live a better life. Oh, it got quiet in here. Are you here with me? Because listen, some of you, you're satisfied where you're at. Están satisfechos. You had faith to get the job.
Amen.
And now you're comfortable in that job.
Amen.
But it's going to take you training that faith that got you the job to move to a higher position, a una posición más alta, to believe God that, listen, I'm not going to settle for just laying here. I need to get up. No me voy a acostumbrar solamente a estar acostado aquí. No, yo necesito levantarme. Look at your neighbor and say, you need to get up. Come on, tell your neighbor, you need to get up. Hallelujah. And it is amazing, church. It is amazing that this is where the church is. The church is paralyzed. Did you hear me? La iglesia ahorita está paralizada. They're satisfied with what got them there. They're satisfied with the things. It's not satisfaction, but God is looking for a church. That if we remember his words, recordamos la palabra de Dios, God said that the gates of hell shall not prevail against the church. Que las puertas del infierno no van a prevalecer, aleluya, contra la iglesia. And that's the church that God is looking for. Not a paralyzed church, but an active church. A moving church. Una iglesia activa. Una iglesia que se mueve. A church that's going to believe God even when everybody else is not believing God. Una iglesia que le va a creer a Dios aun cuando nadie le quiera creer a Dios. ¿Cuántos están aquí conmigo? Are you here with me? And listen, we come in here, I know last night we didn't get to come in here, but we come in here, we've been coming in here on Fridays to pray, on Saturdays to pray, the pastors, we come in here and we come and pray so that you can have a move of God, you can have an experience with God. Venimos aquí, como iglesia, como pastores, a orar el sábado. While you're at home cooking, while you're at home eating your barbecue, cuando se está comiendo sus piernitas de pollo ahí en su casa, we are here as pastors praying so that you can have an experience with God. Para que tú tengas una experiencia. Listen, but can I tell you something? Our prayers will get you into the presence of God. But what are you going to do when you're in the presence of God? Because we got you there. The atmosphere got you there. Nosotros, la oración que tuvimos, que hacemos los sábados, hace que la presencia de Dios baje. Pero ¿qué vamos a hacer nosotros cuando la presencia de Dios baje? See, I got you to Jesus. What are you going to do? Ah, it's quiet in here. Oh, nosotros trajimos la presencia de Dios aquí, que cayera la presencia. Pero ¿qué vamos a hacer? What are we going to do when we're in the presence of God? ¿Qué vamos a hacer, hermano, cuando estemos en la presencia de Dios? You are going to have to believe. Because my faith can only take you so far. Your mom's prayer and her faith got you to get saved. But your mom's faith can't get you to get up and do something, aleluya, for God. La fe de tu mamá hizo que tú fueras salvo, te trajo a los pies de Jesús. Pero tu fe es la que va a activar, la que tiene que ser activa. It has to be activated. Are you here with me? Is anybody in here? So their faith got this lame man to Jesus. So now, this lame man, and I'm going to try to do it, okay? So just bear with me. Because before I could get down here, and then I was going to have a hard time. I'm going to be like a layman trying to get up. And but now I can. So I don't know how these guys got that lame man down. You know, like I told you last week, I don't know. If it was me, I would have just thrown him down from the roof. He's lame. He can't break anything else, right? My daughter, we got home, and she, they were laughing, and they're like, why are you laughing? She said, because when you said if it was you, you would just throw, I could just picture the lame man like this, you know, in front of Jesus. But they had to lay him down right in front of Jesus. Lo bajaron. So now you got a lame man. Now I can get down a lot quicker. Amen? So, we're going to put him like this, right? He's in front of Jesus. Está enfrente de Jesús. They got him this close to Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Lo bajaron, dice la Biblia, enfrente de Jesús. Are you here with me?
Amen.
Woo, Jesus. And some of you are right in front of Jesus. And Jesus is looking at you. And you're looking, you have a perfect picture. This guy's lame. And he's looking at the people that dropped him down. Right? El que está paralítico tiene una perfecta vista a los que lo bajaron. So he's here. He's looking at the people that got him down and say, hey, what did you do that for? I was okay at my house. Estaba bien en mi casa. Are you here? I'm going to be talking like this because I'm talking to the people. I was okay here. Why did you bring me here? I was doing fine at my house. Now look at where you got me. Everybody's looking at me. Todos me están viendo. Now you got me in front of this guy here. Aleluya. Me tienes enfrente de este hombre. She just left me at my house. And the thing about it is that a lot of us blame people for where we're at.
Yes, amen.
I'm just going to let that one float a little bit, okay? muchos de nosotros le echamos la culpa a la gente que nos trajo a este lugar. See, instead of blaming them, you need to thank them that they got you to Jesus. Hallelujah. Debes de darle gracias que te trajeron a Jesús. Now you're in front of Jesus. Are you here with me? And now that you're in front of Jesus, God is going to require you to do something. Estás en frente de Jesús. And God is going to want you to change some situations. Are you here with me? In other words, God is going to want you to change some things in your life. God is going to want you to exchange the mat. Dios va a querer que tú cambies la alfombra, la cama. And can I just be honest with you, as a church and as a people, we are too comfortable with our mat. Oh, come on, somebody. You know, he traded your mat for one of those, what is it, that Tempur-Pedic mattresses. Oh, Pastor, my mat is just so soft, Pastor. I mean, I just push a button and I go up and I go down and nomás le aplasto un botón. So you got so comfortable because there's some things that God is going to ask you to exchange. For some of us, our mat is our attitude. Oh no, I love my attitude, Pastor. Me gusta mi actitud. I can't give you that, Pastor. We love our mat. And we got too comfortable with our mat. And God's gonna require you to change. I'm gonna have to take your, no, not my friends, Pastor. No, no, Lord, not my friends. Don't take my friends away. No me quites mis amigos. Can I tell you something? Sometimes, some of you, your friends are the ones that are keeping you paralyzed. And it's those relationships and those friends, hallelujah, that love to see you down, that they don't want you to get up. No quieren que te levantes, hallelujah. Quieren que estés paralítico. Esos amigos, so God said, I need those friends to be removed from your life, hallelujah. You want to walk or you want to be paralyzed? ¿Quieres caminar o quieres estar paralítico? God said, we're going to have to do some changes here. Are you here with me? Those friends have kept us paralyzed for a long time. Are you with me? So this man is going to have to trade the faith that got him here for the faith that's going to get him to get up. Este hombre va a tener que cambiar la fe que lo trajo aquí a este lugar en frente de Jesús por la fe que lo va a hacer que se levante. Are you here with me, church? ¿Cuántos están aquí conmigo? Aleluya. He's laying right in front of Jesus. And he's about to exchange, trade his faith. Now write this down. If you're writing this down, write this down. Trading faith is exchanging the faith that got you here for the faith that's going to take you there. Cambiando la fe es intercambiando la fe que nos trajo aquí por la fe que nos va a llevar más allá. Are you hearing me? Will you trade it? Will you trade what got you there? Oh, what got you here? See, we got the church. We have faith enough to get this building. Right? Now what? Now we need faith to get us further to the next level. Tuvimos fe lo suficiente para obtener este edificio. Ahora necesitamos una fe que nos va a llevar más allá. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? Is there anybody in here? Everything was good up to this point. Hallelujah. But God never told him that he was healed. God only forgave his sins. Dios nunca le dijo que era sano. Dios solamente le perdonó los pecados. Because up to that point, God said, your sins are forgiven. Did a miracle happen? ¿Sucedió un milagro cuando Dios le dijo tus milagros son perdonados? ¿Verdad que no? God says your sins are forgiven. You know what? He was still lame. Todavía estaba este parálisis este hombre. Because God wanted to do a work inside of this man. Dios quería trabajar adentro. That before it can show on the outside, God says I need to deal with the inside. Antes de que se vea afuera. Listen, because you know when a person is sick because of how they look on the outside. That tells you that something's wrong on them. Right? You look at somebody like, man, you're pale. Are you okay? Something's going on inside. So God says, listen, I don't want to work on the outside. I want to work on the inside. Because if I can get the inside right, the outside will look better. Hallelujah. Are you here with me? So God says, listen, let me work on the inside. Voy a trabajar adentro. Your sins are forgiven. Let's get that stuff inside of you healed first. Let's get that heart that's dirty clean. Vamos a limpiar ese corazón que está sucio. Vamos a limpiarlo. So God says, your sins are forgiven. Your sins are forgiven, but he's still lazy. Todavía está flojo. Todavía la fe de él no lo mueve. It hasn't, nothing's happened. Nobody has seen an outward manifestation of the miracle. Right? Nadie ha visto el milagro por fuera. Everybody's still just looking at him laying down on the floor. Lo miran y está acostado en el piso todavía tirado. They're waiting because up to that point, Jesus, the Bible says he was doing miracles, right? So that means that they were visible, eran visibles los milagros. But for this man, they were waiting for him to get up, esperaban que se levantara. But God says, wait a minute, I need to deal with the inside first. Vamos a trabajar con lo de dentro. Are you with me? So Jesus says, aleluya, in verse 21. Does somebody have verse 21? Can you read it to me? Come on, read it to me real quick. Right in the moment when Jesus said, your sins are forgiven, the haters start coming up. El momento que Jesús le dijo, tus pecados te son perdonados, aleluya, toda aquella gente que te odia empezó a salir. That's what it says, that the haters came out. Are you here with me?
Yes.
Nothing, they hadn't seen nothing, but the haters are always going to be there. Listen, can I tell you something? Sometimes when you're in front of Jesus, you're still going to have haters. Todavía va a haber gente que nos va a odiar. Are you here with me?
Yes.
Hallelujah. But God's going to require this man to do something crazy. Are you hearing me? God's going to require this man to do something crazy. Hallelujah. Continue to read. Read verse 22, please. Jesus knew what the haters were thinking. He said, why do you reason in your heart? In other words, why do you have that? ¿Por qué? He said, Señor, ¿por qué estás contendiendo en tu corazón? ¿Por qué están enojados? Why are you mad? He said, you haven't seen nothing yet, but I'm going to prove it to you. Te lo voy a probar that I am the Son of Man. Que yo soy el Hijo de Dios, that I am the Son of God. I will raise this man up. Yo voy a levantar a este hombre de aquí. Hallelujah. And I want to tell you today, hallelujah, if you're writing these things down, write this down, hallelujah. Trading faith has to hear the hate, but still hold on to the hope. Trading faith has to hear the hate, but still hang on to the hope. La fe, aleluya, cambiante, mi hermano, tiene que oír a la gente que te odia, pero todavía mantenerte con la esperanza de que Dios va a hacer el milagro. Are you here with me? God is still going to do the work. Dios todavía va a hacer el paralítico, que este paralítico camine. ¿Cuántos dicen amén? So, the Bible says that this man was paralyzed, which leads me to believe that he still had his hearing. Right? Este hombre, aleluya, estaba paralítico, que me hace a mí, aleluya, ver que este hombre todavía tenía su oído, que todavía oía. So now, catch this. This man is lame. And now he's got Jesus on one side. And then he's got the haters on this side. And he's watching them going back and forth, right? Está paralítico, he's looking at Jesus talking and he's looking at the haters talk and he's looking. So he's paralyzed. And he's down here saying, well, nobody has asked me anything if I feel anything. Nadie me ha preguntado, a mí dice paralítico, a mí nadie me ha preguntado si yo siento algo. Did I feel something when Jesus said that I was healed or that I was forgiven? So he's looking at both of them, está mirando. And then he looks at the people that are up there because they're still up there. His friends are still up there. Sus amigos están. He says, see what you got me into? I was good. I was watching Friends at home. Some of y'all still watch Friends. I was watching Friends at home and y'all got me here. Now we're fighting. They're fighting here. Están peleando aquí. He's saying that I am. They're saying that I'm not. So look at this mess you got me. Mira el mugrero que me tienes.
Hallelujah.
Are you hearing me? But God, Jesus was trying to do something, and Jesus was trying to prove something, not to the lame man, but to the haters. Jesús estaba tratando de hacer un punto, de demostrar algo, no con el paralítico, sino con los que lo odiaban, con la gente religiosa. Because there is religious people that say, don't take all that. Don't take all that. Are you here with me today? Look at your neighbor and tell him, yes, it does take all that. And the amazing thing, listen, I don't care how many haters you have, as long as you are in the presence of hope and the presence of Jesus, it doesn't matter who's on this side. No importa quién está en este lado, mi hermano, al menos que estés en presencia, aleluya, de la esperanza, en presencia del Creador. Are you here with me today? Everything will be better. Are you here with me? So now, Jesus is going to ask this man to do something crazy. The Bible says that he looks at him. He says, okay, I'm going to ask you to do something you've never done before. But I'm going to need you to trust me. Ahora Jesús le está diciendo a este hombre, te voy a pedir que hagas algo que nunca has hecho. Like many of us, God has asked you to do something that you've never done before. You're going to have to trust God for what he's asking you to do. Vamos a tener que confiar en Dios, mi hermano, para hacer lo que Dios nos está diciendo. Because maybe what God's asked you to do, nobody else in your family has done it. I told you that before. Nadie más en tu familia lo ha hecho. But you're going to be the first one. So this lame man is here. And he's looking at Jesus. And Jesus said, okay, I'm going to ask you to do something that you've never done. He said, stand up. Le dice, levántate. So now, we're going to be real, right? Vamos a ser reales, ¿verdad que sí? The lame man's here. He's looking at Jesus. Jesus said, stand up and walk. This lame man, este hombre para está. Now he looks at the people that are on top. This is my imagination, right? Esto es mi imaginación. It's probably not you, but this is me. Just let me be me, okay? He's looking at the people that got him down. Está viendo la gente. Did you hear that? Now he wants me to get up. Does he not know that I am lame? That I am paralyzed? ¿Acaso no sabe que él, que yo estoy paralizado? Que estoy paralítico? Que no, I can't move. He's asking me to do something that I've never done before. Él me está pidiendo que haga yo algo que nunca he hecho. Did you hear him? Is he out of his mind? Does he not see me the way I am? Hallelujah. And some of you, you are settled that you don't want to believe God. When God tells you to move, you don't move. When God tells you to get up, you don't get up. And God called you for a greater thing. Yo estoy llamado para grandeza. God called you to do great things. But you need to trust God and you need to believe God. If God said it, you better believe it. Si Dios lo dijo, vale más. Que lo creas. He's lame. Okay, Jesus, I don't know if you can see me or not, but I've never moved before. You know, I've just got saved and I've been sitting on this seat for 3 years already, 4 years. I've never done anything like that before. Did y'all hear that? Yeah, because they didn't hear it. So I'm talking to you guys and I'm talking to them, but you guys are listening to me more than they are. See, I got this crazy imagination right now. There's so many things going on in my mind right now. So Jesus, I don't know how to do what you've called me to do. And I believe Jesus said, do you trust me? Well, I ain't got nothing else to lose. I'm already in your presence. In other words, I've already tried everything else, and I might as well try you. Ya traté todo lo demás, vale más hacerte caso. So now he's here like this, however you see him, however he fell in front of Jesus, right? He's like this in front of Jesus. He's like, wow. Hey guys, I can move my fingers. Gloria, Gloria, Aleluya. Can you see? Oh man. Hold on, Jesus. Man, if this guy had to wait a little bit, he's gonna have a hard time trying to get up. So hold on, Jesus. Let me just take 5 minutes. Just, I've never done this before. Nunca he hecho eso. But oh my God. Ooh. Man, it looks different over here than it does down there. Todo se mira diferente. Did you know? Do you know that when you get up and do something for God, everything else looks different? Then when you're sitting down just warming up, bitch. Okay, we'll leave that one for another one. So here is this man, he's trying to get up. Se está tratando de levantar. So the instruction, listen. I'm going to get up because he hasn't gotten up yet, but listen. The amazing thing about God is that he wants us to follow instructions. And a lot of us, we're not good at following instructions. Right? Like when the teacher would tell you, stop talking. What did you do? Keep talking. If you don't stop, I'm going to move you from there to over here. And you kept talking. So she moved you from there to over here. Right?
Yeah.
Or does everybody here follow instructions? ¿Verdad que nadie seguimos instrucciones? We fail at this. So God, listen, God's going to give him specific instructions. Specific instructions. God said, what was the first thing to do? Get up. Look at your neighbor and say, get up. Okay, look at the other one, tell him, get up. Tell him, no, for real, get up. And do something for God. Levántate. Haz algo por Dios. So God said, get up. Jesus said, get up. So here he is. Never moved or never used any body parts in his life. Nunca había podido mover estas partes en su vida. Como nosotros cuando andamos borrachos, you were drunk. Because you have to understand that this man is like a baby.
Yeah.
Es como un niño. He's never used these parts before.
Amen.
And some of you are like babies, but you've been saved for 20 years because you've never used.
Amen.
Okay, we'll move on. Because I still want you to like me. Well, if you don't like me, that's okay. It's okay, right? It's okay. Pastor said, it's okay. Thank you, Pastor. I love you too. Amen. See, I already lost my dream. Can you escort Pastor Rachel to the office? But this man now is not laying down. Now he's in front of Jesus. Ahora este paralítico está parado de pie en frente de Jesús. Now he can move. He can talk. He can hear. And he can walk. Did you hear me? I said he can talk, he can move, and he can walk. Look at your neighbor and say, you can talk. You can move and you can walk. Come on, somebody. Woo! He told them, get up. Getting up means trust. If you're writing down, write this. Get up means trust. Cuando Jesús le dijo que se levantara, Jesús le estaba diciendo, confía. Because listen, this man, in order for him to get up, he had to trust Jesus. Right? Para que esta persona se levantara, tuvo que confiar. Because listen, how many people throughout his life told him to get up? ¿Cuánta gente a través de su vida le dijo a esta persona que se levantara? And he could have came to Jesus and said, listen, I've tried that. Doesn't work. Let's just look for another route. And a lot of us would rather look for something else to do instead of doing what God called us to do. We want to try to go around it. Listen, God, it's not going to work already. Let's just go. Is there another way? So he had to put his full trust in who? In Jesus. Tuvo que poner su confianza, mi hermano, aleluya, en el Señor. And what God is telling some of us today is this. Trust me. Trust that I can get the work done. Confía en mí que yo puedo hacer la obra. Trust me that I can heal you. Trust me that I can set you free. Confía en mí. Listen, God is telling us. I told you this earlier through worship that God, hallelujah, the stars, sustains the stars with his word. So God says, listen, specific instructions. I want you to stand up. Look at the instructions Jesus said. Stand up. I want you to trust me. Confía. Second thing, what does he tell him to do?
Take his cross repeatedly.
Yes. He said, take it. He said, pick up your mat. Toma tu lecho.
Now, catch this. Because if I was the lame man, I would have been running. I would have been jumping. Right?
Yo hubiera corrido. But Jesus is not giving him any opportunity to do anything like that. That the paralyzed man's saying to Jesus, this is my moment. Este es mi momento. I never move. Let's throw a party. Vamos. No, God says, I'm not through with you yet. No acabo contigo, le dice el Señor. So he says, take up your mat. Toma tu lecho. Why? ¿Por qué? Because your mat is your testimony. Porque tu lecho, ese es tu testimonio. This is your testimony. He said, you need to carry your testimony with you back to your job. Carga tu testimonio, aleluya. Yes, we come and we tell you to leave all the mess and the junk. But listen, leave the addiction here, but take your testimony back to your job. Deja la adicción aquí y llévate tu testimonio para tu casa. Take your testimony. Go tell people what God has done. Take your mat, pick it up. Levanta tu lecho, aleluya, dice el Señor. Some of you, aleluya, you have to take your testimony. Because people need to know. People need to know. Where you been? You know, some of us, our kids are going through the same thing we're going through because we don't want to expose what we used to do. Some of us, our kids don't know what we've been through. Muchos de nosotros no sabemos lo que nuestros hijos no saben que hemos pasado. So now you're seeing in your children what you used to go through because you failed to tell them where you went through or what you went through. Did you hear me? Muchos de nosotros, nuestros hijos, están pasando por lo mismo que nosotros pasamos porque nosotros no le dijimos a ellos nuestras experiencias y lo que hemos pasado. And I believe that a lot of us, we have gotten too PG with our testimony. And I can just probably go around right here and I can give you the microphone. And some of y'all gone through some stuff. I mean, like, stuff that you don't tell nobody. Like, stuff you won't want your kids to hear. Cosas que tú no quieres que tú. Some of you, you've been through some stuff. on, let's be real. Pastor, I can't tell my full testimony because it's bad. Yeah, somebody's going through worse than you are, so they need to hear what you really went through. Yeah. Don't give them the PG version of it. Come on, give it to them as it was. What were you? ¿Quién eras? Because you're not that no more. But you had that experience. Tú tuviste esa experiencia. Let them know. Get your mat. Walk with your mat. Toma tu lecho. ¿Cuántos hiciste?
Amen.
So now he, listen, he is up talking to Jesus, and now he's got his mattress. He's got his mat with him. He's got his testimony. Catch this. Now Jesus tells him, what? Jesus says, go home. What? I don't want to go home. I've been there laying at my house for years. Ya no quiero regresar a mi casa. El Señor Jesús dice, vete a tu casa. Toma tu lecho y vete a casa. Now Jesus, I don't know how to walk. You're going to have to teach me one step forward. Never done this before. He said, go home. Why? Why go home? He said, because you are not going to be any good to them here. But you are going to be good to the people who saw you. Hallelujah. Be carried out. Yes. When you came out of your house, you were carried out of your house.
Yes. Right.
But when you go back home, you're going to walk yourself right back into your house. Vete para casa. ¿Por qué? Porque la última vez que en tu casa te vieron, te iban sacando cuatro personas. Pero cuando te vean, te van a ver entrando a ti mismo con tu cama en tu mano. You're going to be walking with your pen, hallelujah, and you say to them, this is the same one, it's just a different position. I traded what got me here for what is going to take me there. He cambiado la fe. I'm trading faith. See, their faith got me to Jesus. And I had to trade that faith for the one you see right now. Now I'm home. Now I can be of good to God by letting people know who really know me what God has really done in my life. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. Some of you need to go home and ask people that you've offended for forgiveness. The people that you've been mean to. The people that you've been giving attitude to. La gente que le has dado actitud. La gente que ha sido malo con ellos. Oh, pastor, but you don't understand what they've done. It doesn't matter. You're not the same person. You're not lame no more. God did a miracle. God got you up. Ay, pastor, es que usted no sabe lo que me hicieron. No importa, usted ya no está paralítica. Usted Dios la sanó, la salvó. God changed your heart. God transformed your life. God said to the Pharisee, listen, I'm going to prove it to you that I am the Son of God. He said, get up. In front of them, he goes, now we're going to see the manifestation. Get up and go to your house. And I want to tell you today that if you've been lame, paralyzed for years because of a situation or because of a person or because of something that you've gone through, God is telling you this morning you need to get up. You need to take up your bed. And you need to go back into your job. And said, something happened to me this weekend. I am sorry what I did on Friday. Yeah, I know I said some things I should have said, I'm sorry. But God changed my heart on Sunday. Dios cambió mi corazón el domingo. Perdóname por lo que te hice. Perdóname por lo que te dije. But God did something. God did something in here that is going to manifest out here. Dios hizo algo dentro de mí que se va a manifestar acá. And then get up tomorrow morning. Cuando se levanta en la mañana, don't forget to take your testimony to work. Somebody needs to hear it. Alguien tiene que escuchar el testimonio tuyo. Somebody needs to know what God really did in my life. But we need to trade our faith this morning. Cambiar la fe esta mañana. Dad, you know what? I'm not who I used to be. Ya no soy la persona que yo era. God changed me. God took that attitude away from me. God took those bad things. Dios cambió mi actitud y esas cosas malas. And now I'm going to do what God called me to do. I truly and honestly believe that when we start taking our testimony and start becoming who God called us to be, people are going to come to Jesus. La gente va a venir a Jesús. Don't post it on Facebook. Be it. No lo ponga en Facebook. Sea lo que está poniendo en Facebook. Be what you post on Facebook. Be what you put on Instagram and Twitter and all these other things. Be that. Don't post it. Be it. Let people see the different you. Because when they see the different you, they're going to want what you have. Ellos van a anhelar y querer lo que usted. Can we stand to our feet today? Póngase de pie. Is there anybody in here that would like to trade the faith that got you to this place for the faith that's going to take you to the next level? ¿Cuántos de nosotros queremos cambiar en esta mañana la fe que nos trajo hasta este lugar por la fe que nos va a llevar más allá? I want you to lift up your hands. I want you to close your eyes. Thank you, Jesus.
You are the Holy Spirit.
God, I pray right now that you will burn all iniquity and all sin. Quema toda iniquidad, quema todo pecado.
If the altar's waiting for us,
God, we are right here, right now. Aquí estamos, Señor. And we need you to burn everything, God. We want to be a living sacrifice. Queremos ser un sacrificio vivo, Señor. Queremos que quemes toda iniquidad, todo pecado. Burn, Father God, the things that are not supposed to be in our life. Lord, today we want to trade this faith that God is this far for the trade that's going to take us to the next level. En esta mañana queremos cambiar, Señor, esta fe que nos trajo hasta este lugar, Señor, por la fe que nos va a llevar más allá. God, today we decide we want to trust you. We're going to stand up because we're trusting you. Vamos a pararnos, Señor. Vamos a pararnos porque vamos a confiar en ti, Señor. We're going to trust you, God. And we're going to believe in you. And God, we believe that when we go home, that means that we're going to be transformed. Hemos sido transformados. We're not the people that we used to be. Now we are a new creation. Ahora somos creación nueva. Ya no somos las cosas viejas, ya pasaron. Ahora todo es nuevo. The old things have passed away. Now all things have become new in my life. Thank you, Lord. We need you today to purify everything in our life. Purifica todas nuestras vidas en esta mañana, Señor. We want to be, Father God, who you called us to be. Ser quien tú nos has llamado ser. We want to be who you called us to be. And believe, God, y creer, Señor, aleluya, que la allá es más mejor que la aquí. Father God, we want to believe that there is better than here. That where you're taking us is much better than where we are at this very moment. That what you are going to do is much better than what you've already done in our life. Que lo que vas a hacer o lo que estás a punto de hacer, Señor, es más mejor que lo que has hecho. And we want to trust you. And we want to believe in you. We want to give you praise and honor and glory. God, we made a decision this morning not to be paralyzed anymore. Hemos hecho una decisión de ya no quedarnos paralíticos, Señor, sino que nos vamos a levantar. We're going to get up, we're going to take our mat, and we're going to go back home and be a witness and be a testimony. Ser de testigo, Señor, ser de testimonio, Señor, a alguien. Somebody is going to come to the feet of Jesus because of my testimony, God. And I thank you, God. I ask that you help us. Ayúdanos. Ayúdanos, Lord. God, we bless. We bless every person that is here today. We give you honor today, God. And we just want to be on fire for you. Queremos estar en fuego por ti, Señor. We honor you today. We praise you today. We give you glory today in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we leave all addiction, attitudes, and all those things here. But we take our testimony with us. Llevamos nuestro testimonio, pero dejamos aquí las actitudes, Señor. Las malas temperaturas. Y nos llevamos el testimonio para hacer la diferencia. I want to be a difference maker. Yo quiero ser la diferencia. Wherever I go, I want to be a difference maker. And I thank you today. And I give you praise, Father. And I give you honor. In the mighty name of Jesus. And all of God's people said, somebody give God praise this morning. I said, somebody give God praise this morning. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is good. And all the time, God is good. Listen, we want to just continue to pray for you, every one of you. We pray for Pastor Kim's family member. We pray for Sister Jessica and Sister Crystal's dad. And anybody else who's going through something, y todas las personas que estén pasando por una enfermedad. Would you help me pray right now? ¿Cuántos me ayudan? Our Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, we pray for Pastor Kim's family member, God. You know all things, God. And you are a miracle worker. You are a promise keeper. You are a light in the darkness. The song says, our God, that is who you are. And God, you have the power to raise her from that bed. Tú tienes el poder para levantarla de esa cama. God, you have power to raise my brother Ben from that bed. And our prayer today, God, is that you would invade those two rooms with your glory this morning. Que invada, Señor, esos dos cuartos con tu gloria. Let your glory invade those places. Right now, as we are praying, let them feel your presence. Let them feel your anointing right there. Que sientan tu unción. Que sientan tu presencia. Que sientan tu gloria right there. Let your glory fill that place and fill their life and get them up from that bed in the name of Jesus. Levántalos. And we pray for anybody else that is going through a situation. I pray for peace upon these families, God, that their faith would increase. Que su fe, aunque la fe de ellos aumente, Señor, de estas familias. These two families, Lord, increase their faith and bring peace that surpasses all understanding. Señor, aumenta la fe y que la paz, Señor, que sobrepasa todo entendimiento, venga sobre las familias. Right now, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. So Lord, we give you praise, we give you honor, and we give you glory right now. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Somebody give God praise right now. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Some of you know that God is good. Some of you know that God is good. Listen, I want to encourage you to come and be who God wants you to be. Ven a recibir para hacer lo que Dios quiere que seas. This Wednesday, we are having our leaders meeting. We're having a meeting for the leaders on Wednesday. Vamos a tener una junta para los líderes este miércoles. If you lead in any area, si ustedes el líder en cualquier área, a las 7:30, we're going to have a meeting here this Wednesday. Amen. When?
Wednesday.
Say it again. When?
Wednesday,
amen. So I want to encourage you to come this Wednesday. If you are not a leader, stand as leader, but if you want to someday become a leader, if you feel that God has called you to that, I want you to come on Wednesday. Venga los miércoles, amen. Hallelujah. Chosen generation, they go back to school August the 29th? We're having lunch. They are having lunch. They are having lunch August the 29th at 12:30. Amen. Sister Christy, Sister Jessica also would like to give the kids some school supplies. So if you have children, si usted tiene niños, por favor, traiga los niños. Bring your children, hallelujah. We have children's ministry. Tenemos para los niños. We have a nursery. And then our youth are going to be starting their own service later on. Van a tener su propio servicio. So we want you to bring your youth as well, hallelujah. So if anybody would like to donate anything for these, for the children, para los niños, please see Sister Jessica, see one of the pastors, Pastor Kim, Pastor Joanne, my wife, Pastor Rachel. See one of us, amen, if you want to help and you want to donate, si te quiere ayudar o quiere donar, please see us as we get ready to not only pray for our children, but also be a blessing to them. También ser una bendición para ellos. Amen. Hallelujah. So listen, we want to thank all of you who came today, todos los que vinieron. Help us pray for Pastor Roland and Diane. They went to Laredo. They're up there ministering. Están ministrando en Laredo. Hallelujah. And I need you to do me a favor. I need you to pray for us. We will be going out this weekend. Este fin de semana que viene, we will be in Dallas with Prophet Joseph Moenia from Dallas. So we're going to be up there this Sunday. But we need you to come. Right? We need you to come. Don't stay at home just because the pastors are not here. We need you to come and still support the ministry as if pastors were here. Amen? Because you're not coming for the pastors. You're coming to receive for the Lord, right? Venimos a recibir. So, la semana que viene, vamos a estar en Dallas nosotros. Los pastores vamos a estar allá. We're going to be ministering up there Friday and Saturday. So, I need you to help us pray. Amen? Because we'll be praying up there with Pastor Joseph and believe for God to do great things over there, but he's also going to do it here. También lo va a hacer aquí. Amen. So we need you to come next week. Be here. Hallelujah. Pastor Roland and Diane will be here. Amen. They'll be ministering. Pastor Jose and Joanne will also be here. Pastor Garcia will be here as well. So listen, please pray for us that God will just move in a mighty way up there. Amen. You're going to pray for us?
Yeah.
Amen. So we're going to get ready to be dismissed. Hallelujah. Pastor Lynn is going to come in and dismiss us, but I just want to let you know that the best is yet to come. Lo mejor está por venir. We love you guys. Los amamos. We thank you. Thank you. Los visitamos.